Hi friends, welcome back to the Pragmatic Lopa. I know this lockdown can be challenging to keep up with high spirits, but don't let the circumstances pull you down and dominate over your creative instincts. Instead, let it work in the most delightful way to surprise you how even such simple things at home can uplift your mood and elevate the overall energy of the house towards positivity. Today, I'm gonna start a series on home decor named Cozy Den. I could have included all in just one video as it's interrelated, but providing all the ideas in one would have been too lengthy, so dividing it into a series of 4 videos. Learn how basic elements lying in and around our house with just simple twists can spruce up any corner. No matter we are locked down at our houses, we can still shape our sweet little cozy home with these easy and quick DIYs with no expertise required and absolute pocket friendly. Without further ado, let's get started with the first one, branches. I collected few branches from my backyard. Use any acrylic paint. I'm using white. Paint them with either a brush or a sponge. If you don't have any or such fancy ones, can use the sponge used for dish cleaning. I was looking for an unfinished, shabby chic look, so did not bother painting it through. Wanted some branch to peek through. Had collected this log of wood from sidewalks when I used to go for my walks to be used as an accent piece for a more natural woody look. I thrifted this gorgeous tall cylindrical vase in one of my favorite combo, copper with matte finish. Use any vase you want or have at home and put in all these painted branches together. Set it up as an easy and simple yet elegant decor piece. For the second one, to add height, I generally reuse empty containers for my DIY projects and contribute my bit towards environment. And now it's time to use it as a razor for the vase, for which I'm using this aluminium foil to give a contrasting metallic finish without spending much. Note, it has a glossy and a matte side. Me being me, will go for matte. After roughly measuring around the container, leave some around 5 to 6 inches extra, tear it off. Keep the glossy part facing the ceiling. So once done, you'll certainly have matte on the outer side. Wrap around. Smooth out edges on top and bottom. This way, try creating crease for a crushed finish. As I wanted more crushed look, removed it and crushed with fingers. Wrap it up again and did not bother about the top and bottom, as anyways it will be hidden. Else would have used a separate sheet of foil to neatly cover them up. To secure it further, apply glue on the container and stick the foil onto it. I did it off camera, but you know, it's easy. For a different decor setup, I wanted a raised look, so put all the branches in the vase and set up the razor underneath. This can be used to add height to your indoor plants as well. Now, just to add different textures and height to the completed look, included more natural elements and contrasting colors. Use this circular wooden block lying at home, which actually is a candle stand, but here it is the base of this glass lantern, which too has a wooden component, and this white metal handle match the branches to make the entire unit cohesive. To add pop of contrast, added this black metal LED glass lantern. Those black triangles on the background definitely makes it well coordinated. Overall, to make this entire corner close-knit, added this log of wood after thoroughly dusting and cleaning with wet cloth and blow drying. Tried my best to keep it as natural as possible, but on one side, for a tint of white, had to dab slightly with a sponge with very little white acrylic paint to make it look cohesive with other white elements. Hope you can appreciate roughly both the halves are of different shades, keeping in mind different decor setups. So it's kind of 2-in-1 situation, or I may say many in one. As in coming videos, you can see when I'll use this natural brown aspect to complement more earthy look and when this white for enhancing various other white components of decor. Keep playing around till you are happy with the final look. Now, to add life, as in warmth, to the existing setup, I had these white string lights from last year festivities. Even you explore your house, I'm sure you would find some too. Simply fill in the glass lantern with these and you're good to go. To add a variation to the branches, I use the same white string lights with warm white glow. Wrap around the branches along the length of the upper two-thirds and leave lower one-third, as anyways it won't be visible outside. Best part is, I had these white lights which easily blend with white branches. Once you set them all, you're good to light it on and enjoy the dazzling corner of your home. And that's how you enhance the beauty of any shallow and boring space in no time without any hassle. Start to look out for options within your house. I'm sure every house would definitely own some lights and random stuffs that can be altered to your preference. So get your creative juices flowing and spread the positive vibe in and around your house. Let your magic speak for itself. Hope you like my creativity, and in case you try out some of these, and if this video helped you in any way, don't forget to acknowledge by a thumbs up and sub if you haven't already. There's a lot of hard work put in, and stay tuned for more interesting decor ideas in coming videos of this series. Thank you for watching. Stay home, stay safe.